Hi, this is TapCat. Welcome to part 45 of Let's Play XCOM 2 with the Alien Hunters DLC. I realize that once again I have managed to have no project going in the Proving Grounds, and we can start building the Rage suit.
Interesting choice. I'll send word as soon as we're finished, Commander.
All right. And I think we are just about ready to go on our mission. If I can remember how to access it, we have quite a lot of enemies that we're going to have to deal with. Kind of rough considering we should only have 12 turns available. I'm not truly looking forward to that. Now, it seems to me like I was going hold on, I remember what I was gonna do. I was trying to think, there was something that I wanted to do, and in particular, okay, so he has a weapon that has no upgrades. Now, I've been passing the same one between he and Paulina, but I actually want to change that. So we're going to give him a superior scope. And I also want to give him a superior expanded magazine, because while the free reloads are definitely a plus for a sharpshooter, when you have kill zone, I feel like this is better if there's a lot of targets, you know, on the battlefield. It lets him hit all of them. So he won't get the free reloads anymore, but that's okay. Now, I do have another scope. Let me see. She's good. She's got the best gear she can get. I don't know exactly what I want for Leah. I guess that's decent. I think it's the best I have for that. So I probably don't want to keep screwing around with this. Normally I try to do all this crap before I start recording. Yeah, I've already got her maxed out, so. All right, let me just check her then, since I think she's literally the only one that I haven't. All right, I must have done that before I started recording. So I think we're good to go. And let's head out. Hopefully we can get that VIP extracted and deal with all of the 16 or more enemies we have to deal with.
Recon picked up a weak distress signal coming from this area. The resistance confirmed it's one of their codes. So we're moving in to provide an emergency extraction. We'll need to secure the area and escort the VIP to the evac point. Stay alert for hostile contacts. Menace 1-5, target coordinates incoming. Secure the VIP and proceed to the evac volume for extraction.
Okay.
Advent already knows we're here, so your position isn't concealed for the extraction.
Well, one of our positions is, in fact, concealed. So let's bring her out. Well, geez, that didn't take long.
Enemy squad located.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so we got an officer and a mech. She can't come up on the roof, which is what I was gonna do, without revealing herself. So I could bring Leah here. Boy. Yeah, this is a little rough. Obviously, I actually feel like ideally I would just start the shooting this turn here And I guess this is the closest position I could get for Leah. And since she can't see, I'm not gonna, you know, just try moving up the few tiles. Okay, you know what's really annoying? I knew that we were not, in fact, concealed. But then somehow I just completely lost sight of it. So I thought, well, let me get her up forward. And anyway, very stupid on my part. But here's the thing. What I really wanted to do was see to what extent I could rip this guy a new one. So I got two ways to go here. I can try for chain shot. I don't love that 71%. So I think I would much rather. We have a lot of shots we can take on these guys this turn. I would rather just do this. There we go. He's hollow targeted. He's shredded. I mean, you know, we have a really good chance to kill him now. And in fact, I may just have him finish the job. I may also have him use lightning hands on this guy. But before I do that, yeah, so this is my main issue right now, is that I have shots I can take, but this guy is behind full cover. And I hate using something like run and gun on turn number one. But I may have to, you know. 61% is a bit crap. And so I think I'm just going to do this. This way, I'll flank him. Sure thing. Yep, this should be pretty much a guaranteed kill. Okay.
Only the best.
And she's got implacable, which I'm going to hold. You know. Well, okay, before I do this, let's think. I have these two. I mean, do I really care more about getting one of them promoted than the other? I don't feel like I do. And since he's obviously good on a rooftop. Done.
What did you expect?
So, let me go ahead and do this. It should be reasonably safe, given what we've already exposed. All right. So, Rose, I will bring, I think there, but can she go even farther? She can, but I don't like that. So, I tell you what if I bring her, this is actually an interesting question. I think I'll bring her here. And I will bring Rose here.
Rolling out.
And I will bring Mr. VIP. Here should be safe. Wait, is that Mr. VIP or Miss VIP? It's kind of looking like Miss VIP. It's hard to tell in that, what do you call it? Lab coat? Ooh, I think we're gonna have company.
Advent troops spotted.
You know, the funny thing is the way that's like a perfect replica of the group we just fought. Now, I do think it's interesting that he jumped right through that window without breaking it. I'm not quite sure how he managed to do that. So I have a really lousy shot at the officer with her, and I think I would prefer not to take it. I could come here and probably even get a little bit better shot at this guy. So that's definitely a thing we could do with her. I could try using the skull mine, but of course if I do that, I could easily reveal somebody out here. I mean, that's a pretty good run forward. You will do nothing. So she doesn't have a great shot, but if I move closer, she might. She actually has a pretty good shot at that guy, which suggests that if I were to move Daria or one of these other guys here, they might as well. And in fact, I think if I moved here or here, anywhere like over here, I think I would both have him flanked and I'd have the elevation bonus. So I rather like that idea. Now, let's start with Rose because I want to unblock that spot anyway. And she'll have full cover here. All right, still only 78%. If I hit, she gets 8 to 10 damage. I don't really want to use the rocket. What's the plasma grenade? 6 to 7, but it's guaranteed. Just out of curiosity, I can't get them both. I could break up some cover, but I'm not sure it would even get rid of those columns, so I think I'm just going to shoot. It's not like 78% is bad. It's not. But you know who I don't remember seeing was Leah. Where is she? She's back here. I thought I had cycled through everybody, but she is actually the one. If I was going to fire first with anybody, it should be her. That's affirmative. So let's move her up. Okay. Let's take this shot first. A little higher percentage, and I get holo targeting. And she just does kick-ass damage against robots, too, so it kind of all works. Yeah, see, now I'm at 93, and it's a kill if I get it, which I did, so that's good. Very, very good. You know, I've talked about this a little bit for the last couple of missions. I'll just repeat it one more time. I really am making an attempt to look a little bit more completely at my turns so that before I start taking a bunch of actions, you know, I kind of know who I'm going to use how. Try to be more effective. What? Okay. Oh, that sucks. That sucks a lot. I think I'm still going to do this. It's pretty much a guaranteed crit. Here's the question, though. No, that's the only one I could get a frostbite. So I'm just going to take this shot. Yeah. I feel like it became more important to make sure that he would not be able to mark anybody and not less, for sure. So, let's see. These mutons, they could climb up here. So, if I were to use Implacable or something to come up here, that could be very dangerous. I think the only one that's close enough to do it is him, but of course the Gatekeeper, he can fly. He is the Peter Pan of robots. He can fly, he can fly. So I fear that her time as a phantom is pretty much done. Because I'm going to have to use the... what's the word I'm looking for here? The Mimic Beacon. It really sucks that I used both of my mechs already. Well, I mean, you know, he has that area of effect power, and I would very much like to not have too tight of a cluster. So, like, I want to come here, but... All right, I'm still going to come here because it's full cover and I can actually shoot. Ugh, why bother? Just out of curiosity, what's this do? Kill all enemies on the battlefield. 100% chance of success. That's not what that does. That's not what that does at all. This is really good. But oh my god, if I failed. So, we've already used up most of our squad this turn. There's no way I would use that now. Yeah, I'm going to say that you should just stay where you're at. So, Anna, should I just come here with you, take the best shot I can at the stupid one of these guys? See, I don't have the Mouton flanked. All right, I'm going to do it. And I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to use... Oh, I forgot about this. Now, there's too many. And if the gatekeeper goes first, we're not going to get any value anyway. Out of the Mimic Beacon, I mean. I need to get a start on killing this fool. I'm not going to use him on the gatekeeper. The question is, do I dare use him this way? If this thing, if they move up. Hold on. So according to that indicator, he would have to dash forward to even be seen by one of them. That means they have to dash forward. Now, Lord knows I've had my issues with that stupid indicator, but I'm going to try to poison this Mouton and weaken his effectiveness. And then what I'm going to do with her is I'm going to use aid protocol on her because she's the one... Actually, should I do it on her or should I do it on Daria? Because she's behind half cover. Oh, no, she's not. No, she's not. She won't be when I'm done. Let's do this. Now, I already said I really don't want to leave her where she's at. I think what I will do is I'll move her over here. Get her full cover. And she got a kill, so actually she's untouchable too. So this guy's almost dead, although, you know, for all the good that does me right now. And they're destructive. Yeah, he always does this stupid thing. So, Anna got hit with it because there's no dodging that. But that Mouton got hit with it, and it looks like that one that I wounded is dead because of it. What the hell? Oh, that was the Mouton. I thought that was the gatekeeper, and I was like, what? How did he do that? Okay. Sorry, I didn't realize for a second that... Okay, so... I'd really like to get her some full cover. And it doesn't seem like that's going to happen. So, I could actually move back, but I really need her on this guy. That's the problem. So, I think what I'll do is I'm going to move back a little. No, I'm going to move right here. Order's confirmed. Trying to strike a balance between keeping a halfway decent shot. Okay, this is perfect because she's got the blue screen rounds. So if I hit while he's unprotected, you know, I'll do really nice damage. So part of me wants to go for chain shot because we just get the kill straight up. But that's really risky because I could just miss. So I feel like it's more important to do this. Okay. Yeah, but that's okay. That's okay. Now, wait, I thought I shredded the 3 armor. Oh, that's right, but he starts with 7. Isn't that wonderful? Okay, so what I want to do is I want to use her to finish this guy. But if I'm going to do that, then he needs to be hurt in some way, shape, or form. Apparently, it's not going to be by him. But you know what? Let's use him to kill the mouton. Before I do, I'm going to stick to my pledge. So what can Rose do? She has a very poor chance at the one that I really want to hit. I feel like I need to use her for one heal at least. Okay. Everybody can hit the zombie that I don't care about. She has a poor shot at this guy that I really need to hit. So I think the reality is I need to use a grenade here. And the only one who can use a grenade is her. That is the dealio. Now I can. Life is good sometimes. Life is good. I mean, you know. Do I even need to say more than that? All right, Anna. You have been officially unshackled. I'm tempted to have her kill this guy, but she's got the ammo that just goes right past the armor. Let's use it. Bye-bye, zombie officer. And I'm probably just going to have her claim the loot. But, before we do that, okay, a little nerve-wracking. I'm going to come here. Make sure I get the flank. I could have tried the grappling hook. That was probably a mistake. But this should work out. Yep.
That's right.
Okay, so actually, I might as well just do this.
Sure thing.
Valerium core. Wow, the superior expanded magazine that I just used got replaced. And the superior scope just got replaced. That is pretty funny, actually. So I think what I'll do while I have the chance is I'll go ahead and reload him.
Back in.
Now, the question is, should I move forward? And I think so. We've already used up a couple of our turns, and while that doesn't sound like a lot out of 12, it kind of is. Okay, I'm not going to bother with the hack at this point. I guess I will... Honestly, I'm not even sure I'll ever bother with it. It's just not that important. How many do I have left? Okay, not much. I'm going to move her here. As we've kind of flushed out this area. And I don't really want anybody going up on the roof just yet. And then I think I'll just move her here. And I'll go on Overwatch. And I guess I don't want to leave her where she's at because, you know, technically she could take fall damage if that fire spreads. And I just realized, you know what I want to do before I do anything else with my turn? I need to, unfortunately, use a turn of hers to just get Anna back up to full health from that vicious little AoE that she took, and then get Leah back up to strength after that mouton shot her. Sorry about that, Leah. I did put you behind half cover, and yeah, that's kind of always a dicey thing to do. So, all right, with that done, let's go ahead and just move her up. I mean, I hear something out there, probably an Andromedan, because I don't think there's a sectopod out here. Okay, I'm probably going to reload each of these two guys this turn. See, I'm really anxious about where I bring these guys right now. And I don't think I want her over this far. Oh, actually, that's the exit point. I was thinking it was over here. Whew, okay. Then I'm not moving her at all. I'm going to reload. And I'll go on Overwatch once I've moved everybody else. So he's already reloaded. Can I just do something like this? Is that safe? Yeah, they've already moved farther than that. Although he could be flanked, theoretically. What about coming here? And if there's anybody over that way, it's crap. I'll come here. We'll see what happens. Now, we have only fought, let me think, 10 enemies only. But remember, they identified 16. And you know what I'm seeing an awful lot of the time is they'll tell me there's 13, and we fight like 20 guys. So I've kind of learned to take their number as a bare minimum and not as any kind of real number. I'm not sure I want to move Rose forward unless I come like up here. She doesn't badly need a reload. Okay. See, I don't want to go up that pipe. Yeah, I'm worried about coming over this way, and I don't really want to send any more guys right behind them. So I think what I'll do is I'll come up part way, because they were right there. And then, rather than reload her, since she's almost at full anyway, I'll just do that. Now, can I send him by Leah somewhere where he would be safe? I'll do that. Now that I know where the exit point is. I'll be honest, if I don't end up fighting everybody on this map, I really don't care. I always practically give myself a stroke worrying about getting out of these things quick enough. So if for once we are able to kind of beeline, hostile interceptors are inbound on your current position. Okay, still have to get up there. All right, well, I think here's what I want to do logically. I'm going to move forward with Leah. I'd like to move up more. You know, the problem is just
I'm on the move.
I don't want to dash. I really don't want to dash because there could be somebody around that corner. Let me get Daria. She's the quick one on her feet. Boy, no high cover. Yeah, okay. I tell you what, I'll come here.
Not a problem.
I'm just only going so far here. Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you knew, didn't you? Really? Oh, you know what? I said I fought 10 guys. I fought 8. I fought 2 pair of mechs and officers. So that's 4. And then the 3 mutons plus a gatekeeper. That was another 4. So I fought 8, not 10. This makes 10. So there's like a good 6 guys left minimum out here. That's rough. Okay, so I'm assuming, yeah, he has a really good shot at each. You know what I really want to do is come right here and see if I can just kill her right now. How dangerous is that? I could trigger a group up there. I'm going to do it. I don't think playing scared is smart, and it's not like I know. There could be a group anywhere. right? And I'll reveal them or not. I could step one tile to, you know, this way and reveal them. Like, I never know.
Sure thing.
Well, now I know. It's okay. I mean, I'm actually not that fussed about it. So I said 10. I want to keep a good count. This would give me 13, but I also need to remember there are now three codexes, an Andromedan and an Archon. Before I take this shot, I think what I'm going to do, though, is try and freeze somebody. I was thinking about the Archon, but I think I'll go the other way. Let me try and get her. All right, that'll help a little. Now, do I want to do anything else? I don't think so. I'm content to kill this thing. Okay.
Only the best.
And now she can both move and she gets the whole untouchable thing. So let's see where everybody is. I'm fine just coming here. Now watch, I'll trigger another group. Okay, I didn't trigger another group. Okay, I do not want to hit the Archon. And that's the only thing she can hit. So that's a little awkward. He can hit the Archon that I don't want to hit. And if I start hitting those things, I have to worry about the fact that they're going to split. That really sucks. But unfortunately, I probably am just not going to have much of a choice on that. As far as Rose goes, I think it only makes sense to move her forward. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to see what kind of chance she has to hit everybody. Okay, so I'm probably going to take that shot. But again, it won't kill her. It'll just hurt her. I might use your hack now. But if I do, you ain't going to do anything meaningful this turn. But given the fact that there's no cover, I'm not going to have much choice. You are going to stay right where you're at, hunkered down. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to kick things off with Rose. I'm going to take this flank. If we're lucky, we could even get a kill here. We did it. We did it. So that's two of the three codexes down. That's pretty awesome. And the other one is frozen. So the Andromedan and the Archon, those are our main threats now. Actually, what I'm going to do, he's the only one I can hit with lightning hands. Then I'm not going to use lightning hands. That's what that means. I'm very tempted to take this shot. What I dislike is how much of his damage the armor will block, as well as the fact that he's immune to poison. So actually, even though I know it's a little nonsensical because it's frozen, but it won't stay frozen. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to try to start working my way towards ending the threat of this codex. Because it can't even split right now. It's down to 5 health. Now, I guess I could do this, but she can't actually hit the codex. She can almost hit the codex, but I'd hit the Archon, and again, I don't want to. That's the problem. Because it's very unlikely I'm going to kill him. Right? Who else could go? Even if I move her forward, it's really unlikely. But I get you. All right, hold on. I'm going to have like a 60% chance at a crit here. She's behind half cover, and then this fool comes out. Okay. I have a plan. Part one of said plan. I'm going to go away from what I said. I was hoping he would use Blazing Pinions, but instead, I'm gonna go for damage. Start killing this guy. Now, next. There we go. Gonna move her forward. She has a very good chance. And I'm gonna use it. I'm just gonna shoot. Well, his dodge is definitely working. Now. Depending on how that went, I was very, you know, conflicted about what to do with her. No, I'm not really conflicted anymore. So I could use run and gun, like I said, but I'm not gonna. So what we're gonna do is I'll just put the Mimic Beacon down. I mostly am worried about that stupid Andromedan. And so I'm going to put it where he can see it. And she's still frozen. So very unlikely that one of them will get the solo kill. Okay. I guess that gets me to 16. But not what I was looking to have happen. Woo, it lived, if only just. All right. Yeah, this is a bit rough, actually. We have two Andromedans on the field. Oy. And then, a Stun Lancer, and is that a trooper back there? Yeah, it's a trooper. Okay, so as much damage as somebody like Daria, you know, can deal out, I mean, it's not unlimited. See, what I was thinking we would do this turn is we polish her off easy peasy. Even the Archon's not that hard to kill. And then we just hammer away at this guy. But boy, this is just so much harder now. So let's start thinking. Definitely one of the things that makes this stuff so much harder is the way you can shoot at an Archon and think you're going to do a ton of damage. And then they just dodge. So, let me do this. I feel like he's only good against some of these guys, like the Archon, yes. And then this thing, yes. Now, on one level, you go, wow, it's frozen. Why do you really care? Yeah, but I do care. Okay, so I think this is kind of a no-brainer. Let's use the Lightning Hands. Okay, and it didn't dodge for once, so that helped. It's also poison, you know, so if we don't manage to kill it. The sad thing is, I may need to get him in there so I can use this frickin' frost bomb on one of these Andromedans. Because, man, I got some real issues here. One thing I also think I should do. Let's see. What if I did something like this? Boy, what does it take to... Oh, I'm not... Am I really not able to get far enough to hit the Archon? Or, excuse me, Andromedan? I Gotta be kidding me with that crap. Wow. So I'd have to move closer. Which I could do. And, you know, I think I will. I feel like I gotta start, you know, making some headway here. Alright. So this will kill the codex. And we'll get rid of the armor for the Andromedan. That's no small thing. Okay. Good deal. And he's not going to feel the burn, right? Because he uses acid. That's like his weapon, so you don't get to have it be effective against him. Okay. Leah. I wish he could go up there. I'm trying to find good cover. Good cover where she can actually still do something. So I think I'll come here. Now, ideally, what I would do is I would use her against an Andromedan after, you know, it's killed. You know what I should probably do with him? Especially since he has 5 ammo and there's like 6 guys here. Might need to use kill zone. So let's hold him. Do I move her here? I think so.
Moving to position.
I certainly don't want to leave her where she was. Why do you torture me like this, XCOM? Why? You know, if everything goes perfect, you can almost do what you need to do. But you won't, just so you know. You know what I'm really tempted to do with her is just come back in here and kill one of these guys, but I don't have run and gun or anything. What if I just came... I don't have the mimic beacon anymore either. But if she got the kill, that would help a lot. Oh, I have cover. It's not good. Okay, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to move her. Actually, even though I hate using it this way, no, I'm not going to. Yeah, okay, I am gonna. This seems like total overkill, but I could easily not get the crit, and if I don't get the hit, I may not get the kill. I need to do everything I can to make sure I kill this guy. And I missed. Even though she had a really high chance, I missed. Alright, screw it. Okay, we got it. So... that's, again, it's important because now I get implacable. Now she gets untouchable. And otherwise, she could die. Just straight up, she could die. Now, where can she go? I could come back here. He'll flank me, but I don't really care about that. The problem is there was another guy back there who could possibly flank her. I just need to make up my mind, huh? Making up your mind, it's a good thing, but boy, there's like nothing. What if I come here? I think I'll do this. Most of them will have an awkward shot, and she'll have a good shot at this guy next turn. So you only have a shot at him. What if I used a gas bomb in there? The problem is, the wall is standing, so I wouldn't get to one of them. You know, I could do something like that, but it's kind of crap. Yeah, that's a bit junk. But I don't have a better option. Unless I did this, like just totally go for broke. Yeah, why not? Let's try to really wreck this guy. Alright, it didn't work. I don't know. You can say it's a bad chance, but she didn't really have, like, an amazing shot anyway. And I feel like, you know, swing for the fences. Hey, maybe something really good happens. All right. I'm going to do this. I'm pretty sure the one guy is going to go forward, or he ain't going anywhere. So now I have to make a choice. I either fire at him, or I put... what you call on her aid protocol. And I'm actually thinking I'm going to put aid protocol on her. Even with untouchable, she's behind half cover. And there's like a million guys they get to tear up. So I'm going to do that. Oh. You know, I'm ashamed to admit it. I completely forgot about her move. And what really sucks is how poor all of her choices really are. All this half cover everywhere. I mean, there's like, I could come here. I think I will. I'm going to try to set us up so that I just know I can kill that one guy next turn. And if that means she doesn't get much done this turn, whatever. I just don't want to hang her out to dry. Miss. Get untouchable. But again, you have the whole rest of the crew, and she has no cover. Okay. The beginning. I'm actually really glad he came towards us like that, too. Oh, there goes the AoE. I hate you. This is what it feels like when somebody uses an acid bomb on you. I don't think anything of it when I do it to them. I killed him. It's huge. So the trooper's no more. Is this the Stun Lancer now? Yeah. It's not dead, though. Yeah, I know. Oh, that's not good. That's not good. Oh, that's not even a little good.
All right, that one hurt. I think I'm bleeding.
Okay. Oh, damn you. Okay. Daria, if I just leave you right where you're at, can you get this kill? I can't see his health bar. I'm going to do 11 to 13 plus the crit. God. Yeah, seriously, I'm looking to see if I'm just missing it on the screen. I don't want to count all these stupid bars. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That's a lot more than 13. So somebody needs to hit him first. And I'd rather it not be Anna. Let me try him. Oh, do I need to use a frost bomb? Yeah, I think I do. I think if I want to live through this and try to get out of here. So let's do this. Let's reload. And then throw a frost bomb. Okay. So, Leah and Rose. Okay. Well, all right. I'm going to do this. He's not dead. Awesome. He's at one health. Of course he's at one health. Why would he not be? Oh, I hate this game sometimes. There are two guys we absolutely, positively have to kill this turn. So that is what I intend to do. Okay. Oh, and you know, I don't know why, but I just completely blanked on the fact that this guy gets a second life. Okay. So, unfortunately, I'm going to have to leave Daria where she's at, and I need to bring her over here.
Whatever you say.
Where, unfortunately, she could still be attacked. Actually, can I do this? Will she get... I guess not. It doesn't say she'll get poisoned. Okay. Or, not poisoned, but acid burned, I guess what I'm trying to say.
Not too shabby.
Okay, so now she gets implacable. And I'm going to move her over here. In the hopes that she can take care of this guy next turn. Now, I'm actually going to start moving this guy forward, I think. Okay, I actually don't want to move her, so I'm going to stay right where I'm at. And next turn, he's going to thaw. Yep, this is what I was counting on. That's right, sucker.
I need some help. I don't
yeah, I know. Please shut up. Okay, so thank God we're done with the whole, never mind. I was going to say the acid is all. Okay, how do I do this? I need to put as much of a beating on this guy as I possibly can. At the same time, I need to make sure I kill him. I feel like what I need to do is I need to bring Leah in close.
Move into designated position.
She's going to do a ton of damage to this robot. Yep. Okay. And she can do a ton of damage to this guy. In fact, they should just get the kill. So that's pretty perfect. I don't need to reload or anything. So let's just do it. I did not get the kill. I did not. That's really bad. Really bad. Because even if I do something like this, now once you get through the armor, he's very likely to have like one health left. And I can use Daria to kill this guy, which I think is what I just need to do. Unfortunately. So frustrating. Okay, so that's one down. I still have Hudson, by the way, and I'm very aware of that. I also am wanting to come over here. Although I don't like using her for this because I'd really rather use somebody who, or I'd rather put her up here and tempt him to attack her.
Finally.
And she's almost dead. See, this is a real issue. I just got to try and kill this guy, or at least this incarnation. Okay, we did. But he still has that other life. So I'm almost out of actions. Yeah, I don't want to get too close, thanks. He can't fire, so I'm not worried about that, really. But it just doesn't pay to get any, you know, like get where he could actually take a swing. Now, I can take a shot, and I think I might as well. I don't see any downside to this. He can't be poisoned, unfortunately, but he can be hurt. So, could have been a whole lot worse. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to blast him. This should pretty much kill him or come very, very close. Very, very close. Not worried about the difference right now. Because Leah is going to end this. Done.
Target neutralized. Draining ammo fast.
Now, Daria, you pick her up, please.
You're with me.
And you're leaving.
No need to ask twice.
Because I ain't letting her die. I said a while ago, no more deaths. And I meant it. We don't have another med kit, but we're near the extraction point. So I'm out of here. Okay. I'm moving our scientist so that she can get out of here if she needs to. I'm gonna bring Rose here.
Solid copy.
Nobody else needs to leave this turn, but I want to make sure even if reinforcements come, like everybody can get out. And I think we can next turn. I mean, we're...
Menace 1-5, hostile interceptors are on high-speed approach. Your window for extraction is closing.
I'm aware.
VIP secure and in position for evac.
VIP is secure.
Who's the farthest away? All right. It's just these guys. We're good.
Location confirmed.
We got some hospital time for sure. We had a lot of really tough enemies there, and I just don't know that all of that was avoidable. So, honestly, like, I don't really feel badly about how I managed those fights. Now, I moved forward with Daria that one time, and I knew I might reveal another group, but that wasn't really the problem. The problem was when the other group came forward on patrol. Before we could deal. Like, if we'd had one more turn, we'd have been fine. So, but the good news is we got Jennifer out of there before she bled out. We got the VIP out. You know, no deaths. Got wounds. We can handle wounds. Everybody was healthy coming into this. So, you know, I'd rather not have them. But, at least nobody died because, boy... They dumped a truckload of enemies on us all in one shot there. And a lot of tough ones too. Those stupid Andromedans. Man, they're bullet sponges. The thing that I'm kind of measuring myself by right now, actually, it's not even so much how many soldiers got killed, how many soldiers got wounded, although, of course, those are very important. But it's the idea of You know, am I doing something in a turn? And then 10 seconds later, I go, oh, damn, I should have done this first. Oh, I should have used that soldier first. Or am I approaching it with a, you know, a reasonable plan? Am I kind of, you know, using my tactical options well? And you may disagree, but I feel like I did okay. The only thing that I would change if I could, or at least I would try to, is I feel like I might have come back with a couple of extra grenades, you know? Is there a time I could have used them more effectively? I'm actually not sure that there was. Okay, well, I think deep cover is one of the worst abilities a ranger could take, and I think untouchable is amazing, so yes. And it's funny that she's not lightly wounded when she only took 3 damage, but so be it. And that's the only loot we got. No corpses on these extraction missions. So it is a female. Sorry about that, ma'am. I didn't mean to call you a guy or sir or whatever it was I said the one time. All right. Well, the good news is I mentioned a couple missions ago that if we could get a couple of scientists, it would probably add up to a reasonable, you know, drop in our... Wait, am I already doing this? Yeah, okay. In our research times, and now I've gotten a couple, so. Do I need more intel? Don't know. Hang on just a second. Where am I at as far as, so I've got the shadow chamber. Okay, we have 2 training here. The rage suit is going. I guess I don't need to be training any people. What I would like to know is, what does all that translate to? So Jennifer, as you might imagine, for somebody who is bleeding out, has got the longest recovery time. But the others, 9 or 10 days. We could easily be without them, but we'd be okay. We'll be okay. All right, let's go. What was I working on when all that started? Here it is.
Setting course for the Australian.
I went that way and it was right down here. Given how close this counter is, it's probably about time to go to some of these facilities. Indeed, sir. What would that cost? A ton. More than I have. So that qualifies as a ton right now, as far as I'm concerned. Do I want to do this? I could get a little more intel, have enough maybe to... open that up if I want to, but I don't really need to. What's the bonus for Asia? Yeah, we have very little left on the tactics. This we've already got. That we've already got. It's the one I was just looking at. So Australia is one of the few, if not the only bonus we don't already have. Is that true? Wow, that's amazing. So I've really opened most of the map at this point. All right, I mean, if it's not too egotistical, can I just say I think that's pretty good? I'm actually really tempted to just come here. Andromeda and Mouton. I mean, basically, this is kind of a standard mission, and we'll start knocking some of this stuff out, slow down their progress. I'll go here too, but why not wait until our guys, maybe we get one of these guys ready or something. So why don't we do that? When we come back, we'll go to an alien facility. But that's all for now. Thanks for watching. I hope we see you next time.